Welcome to the EA Sports Tournament of Legends. Let's see how the Midwest region will play out. Tonight we've got an interesting matchup at the shooting guard position. Number 15 is a great outside shooter that seems to have unlimited range when he gets it going.
Starting across from him tonight will be another player that is known to be a great shooter himself.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Time for the tip-off.
Play ball, baby. Play ball as Zebra tosses it up.
And we're underway. They're working around the arc. Ooh. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Gets a hand in the way. The ball goes out of bounds. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
And that what makes college so special, the enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Nice pass to the low block. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And a big rebound.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
Up and in.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
From the top of the circle, Allen picks up the defensive foul. First personal foul. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Gets the first. Working it around the perimeter.
A little frustration right there.
They work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds to put it up. Tries for two. The layup.
Up and inside.
Up and in.
to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
10 on the shot clock. Tries the turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
The Jayhawks are obviously known for their up-tempo style and mentality, Dick.
These guys aren't afraid to force the issue, Brad. That's for sure. Talk about forcing the issue. These guys are at their best when possessions are short and the speed of play is frantic. Probably one of the most entertaining styles of play.
With a rejection. Gave it up.
Block shot usually creates.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
The lay-in. Now they get some additional instruction from their coach for this defensive possession.
Look at that spacing.
There's a high screen. He puts up the J. He sinks another basket. What are they going to do with this guy, Dick?
I don't know, Brad, but they better do it quickly.
Here comes the ball screen. For the bucket. Up and in. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. With tons of room. He misses badly on that three-point attempt. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
That's exactly what I was thinking, Brad. The pace of this game has been remarkable.
On the inside. On the dribble, gives it up. Three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA, Aaron Andrews, checking in from the sideline. Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Johnson handles the feed. Cross court. Number 15 picks up the foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
So they'll inbound on the near sideline.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The lay-in. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Ten seconds to get a shot off. Up and in.
Roll that replay ready, boys.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Bruins head coach has been content with his team's current style of play. They are controlling the tempo by slowing things down. Now, at the moment, this style of play is in their best interest. It plays to their strength as a team. Expect for this tempo to continue as the game goes on.
That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. Now they work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds on the clock. Washington receives the pass. Nails the jumper. Arthur may have escaped one there. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
They work the perimeter. He's in the clear. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
Well, he will, Brad, if they don't get somebody on him in a hurry.
Moving it around the perimeter. He could not get more wide open. Dickie's simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Number five handles the feed. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Gave it up. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. Cross court. They get an open three. Sinks the shot. Got a guy right on him on the pass. Looking for a good shot. They get an open look for three. Gets it to go. Collins receives the pass. For the bucket. The lane. On the dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Pulls down the board.
Dump it inside.
He shoots from left of the circle, knocks it down. Both teams looking to get things going here. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Off the rim and no good. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us. Erin?
Dick and Brad, I'm sure you can hear and see Coach yelling from the sidelines. He wants the team to start forcing the issue on offense. In his opinion, the tempo needs to increase. Based on his team's personnel and his coaching philosophy, I guess he feels that this will give his team a better chance at getting the win. Guys?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline report. They get that rejected. Up and in. Johnson receives the pass. For two, the lane.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Erin Andrews.
Well, guys, the difference in scoring jumps out at me. It's a matter of one guy focusing and taking advantage of his shot opportunities, and he's making the most of it.
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Gave it up. Now the turnaround jumper. They take it off the defensive glass.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Inside. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing off is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Rush handles the feed. Off the mark. Going to move it around the perimeter. Ten seconds. Show it swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Pushes it up. The Jayhawks are on the run. Goes up for two. Way off target. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
If you haven't noticed, the coaching staff really wants the team to get it going. They've been pleading with their players, get it going, speed up the pace. Up-tempo is what they're all about, and the coaching staff would like for them to get back on track.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there, let him think about it for a while.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up and get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
For the bucket. Off the rim and no good. They work it around the perimeter. Launches away. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Trying to feed the low block. Now the turnaround jumper. He's not even looking for the open man, Dick.
They might need a quick TO, baby.
On the outside. With all sorts of time, he gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show is about to start, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Seconds showing on the shot clock.
Nothing but nylon. Nice smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Number four takes the pass. Cross court. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, took a chance, and he lost, baby.
He tries to beat the buzzer. Perfectly executed. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Bruins. Coaching staff are pleased with the current tempo in which their team is playing. They aren't forcing the issue, and they're taking their time offensively. Their style of play is unhurried, and that's how the coaching staff would like for them to play.
EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad.
Very important.
Tries for two. Up and in. Cross court. For two. The lay-in. Side. Goes up with it. Buries the deuce. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Up and in. Number five takes the pass. They'll work it around the arc. Gets it off in time. The lay-in. Gave it up. Goes up for two. And he missed. Pushes it up. Two for one opportunity. And off the mark. He tries the three ball. Knocks it down. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game. Richard?
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Collins receives the pass. The two ball's good. It. Can't get the shot to drop. At halftime, the Jayhawks are down by four. We've had a very tight contest tonight, Dick. What's your highlight of the half?
Check out this dunk, which changed the momentum, Brad. I wouldn't doubt if the next half is filled with more highlight reel dunks. Looks like both teams are trying to one-up one another.
Well, let's head back down to the court for the start of the second half. Kansas has struggled to control the boards in that first half, Dick.
They're not playing with the same intensity and passion that I've grown accustomed to seeing. The coaching staff must be a wee bit worried about what is going on with their squad.
Dick, it's all about teamwork, and as we start the second half and take a look at our player matchup update, it's pretty even.
That's a really great balance out there because you look at the stars right now, they're getting the ball in the right place on the court where they can be effective.
Tries for two. Up and in. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For two. Perfectly executed. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Jayhawks. From what I could hear during halftime, really want to change their focus to offensive rebounding. They did a poor job of this in the first half, and they believe that there may be some easy putback and second chance opportunities. This point of emphasis falls in line with their style of play and should help them get the W. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Takes the rebound.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Goes up for two. They still don't score. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. On the shot clock. The small forward gets the pass. For the bucket. The layup. Tries for two. Up and in. Number 12 gets the ball. For two, the layup.
I tell you, Brad, what a breakdown defensively.
And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
And they get the turnover. Now in transition.
Good drive right there, good penetration.
Working it around the perimeter. Ten on the shot clock. He shoots from the elbow. Jumper won't go. The small forward with the ball. Get the hoop to fall. The Bruins are all about half-court style.
They'll never force a shot and will rarely get into a running game, Brad. They realize that they can't play that style and be successful.
They work it around the perimeter. Up for two. In and out. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
Arthur receives the pass. Inside. Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
He's all alone. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, they'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
He attempts the jump shot. The Bruins have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brad, he's on fire.
A little two-man action.
Escape the trap.
Rush receives the ball.
Up and inside.
Ten seconds to shoot. He takes the open jumper. He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team. Get in the flow. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket, number 15 is called for the foul. Second personal foul. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
misses the second. Grabs the rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Tries for two. Up and in. The power forward takes the pass. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player to attack the basket.
Washington receives the ball.
Look at that spacing.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He knocks down another bucket.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. The lay-in. Looking for a good shot.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Up and in.
Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
There's a slam. Pushes it up. For two. No good. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
That's a great indication of how frantic the pace has been, Brad.
Johnson handles the pass. Gave it up.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad.
And an momentary look from three-point land. Ten seconds to put it up. Now they work it around the perimeter. With a jumper. Off the mark. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
A little half-court action and a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
There it is, Jam City.
Jackson receives the pass. He intercepts it. The Bruins pushing the ball in transition.
Look at this going coast to coast. Nobody stops the ball. I mean, he just has an open lane, man. You can run that truck through there.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The Jayhawks can't seem to establish the tempo and impose that frantic style of theirs on the opposition, Dip.
This team wants the number of possessions to be higher than usual. Quick scores with quick stops and pressure at the defensive end is definitely their style of play.
Pushing in transition.
Nice looking bucket off the break, Brad.
The Bruins like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
Half-court teams really will rely on each other. They'll not get any easy baskets, so they basically got to execute offensively by really moving the basketball and setting some good screens.
They work the perimeter. There's the pick, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Perfectly executed.
Defense.
turnaround jumper. The lay-in. As we continue to track the game's tempo,
these teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Oh, what a great job, transition offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert, get the number game going.
They go into the low block, 10 on the shot clock. Perfectly executed. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
In the paint.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Ah, I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Cross court. Gets the ball and now faces his man down to the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, it's a matter of one guy focusing and taking advantage of shot opportunities. He seems to be making the most of it tonight.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Thanks, EA. Aaron Andrews providing that extra bit of insight for us.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure. If substitutions aren't made in the near future, I can guarantee you that there will be some missed shots and silly mistakes.
On the dribble, gives it up. 10 seconds, showing on the shot clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Cross court. Goes up with a shot. And come up short. Gave it up. Ten seconds, showing on the shot clock. He can't get the bucket to fall. Collins handles the pass. Moving it around the perimeter.
Great pass out of the trap, Rod.
Kicks it out. He throws up the shot. He misses the jumper. The Jayhawks aren't pushing the ball and forcing the tempo, and that's what they usually do. I can't quite figure it out, Dick.
Hey, playing up tempo is their philosophy. Quick scores, quick possessions are factors which often lead to their success. They've got to get back to that style.
Picked off. Here they go in transition.
Great finish off the transition, Brad.
Check it out here, a nominee for our Pontiac game-changing performance. Pushes it up. Count the bucket, that's a goaltending violation. Number 13 gets in on his first minutes tonight.
Hey, this kid really knows how to keep the offense moving. Tremendous leader out there.
The shooting guard gets the ball. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
With a layup. for two. The lay-in. The Bruins like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
When they do those types of things, Brad, they get into a rhythm. Everyone knows that rhythm is crucial for offensive success in basketball or for any sport, for that matter. That's definitely a correlation.
Up and in. Looking for a good shot. Ten on the shot clock. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Got it! On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Two with a lay-in. The small forward takes the pass. Tries the turn and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Kicks it out. He shoots from long range. Questionable shot selection there.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Number 40 receives great block shot. Fed the low block. Looks at a three. He gets it to fall. Gave it up. He goes for the trifecta. Sinks the shot. The shooting guard gets the pass. Nice hops. Goes up for two. The lay-in. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Here they come now on a turnover. Well, that was just coast to coast for the score. And we're back to a two-point game. On the dribble, gives it up. The Jayhawks have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Passes it out of the trap.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He's all alone. He gets the shot to fall. Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
As a head coach, Dick, what are the types of things that would be really going through your mind at any one time?
Hey, Brad, there's never just one thing. That's the beauty of it. You're always anticipating, evaluating, and assessing the situation. So many things come in and out of your mind when you're on the sideline. I think good coaches will operate in this manner and ultimately make the right decision at the right times.
He forces another bad shot.
That is not how you win ball games, Mr. Nessler.
Any final thoughts regarding the points of emphasis, Dick?
Brad, a good game plan is important. The points of emphasis are a great guide in helping teams focus on the key components. Components which will help a team get that W.
You've got to know your style and play within it. Such an important part of the game. Let's check out today's top play, the Pontiac game-changing performance. Nick, you know, it's always great to look back and see how the marquee matchup has played out.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, that's great to watch individually, but remember, this is a team game, so it's really how the team responds as a unit.
Kansas couldn't come together quickly enough tonight as they lose this close one.
It's always tough to lose to a team that you know you can beat.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.